Hi guys, this is Sushant, Kochar, and today we are going to talk about what are the disadvantages of intermittent fasting. So till now we have discussed a lot of advantages of this intermittent fasting. Now we should discuss about disadvantages also. So till now we have talked about the advantages of fat loss, muscle gain. It can get you rid of really big diseases. It does purification of your body, detoxification, removal of waste from your body, improves your organs' health. It gives you longer life, delayed aging, and last but not the least, upvas, which is one day fasting, is said to be the best medicine according to spiritual texts, Shastra. Okay, so many benefits, but what are the disadvantages? I cannot recall any disadvantages. There are no any significant disadvantages, except that you would have to restrain yourself when you are trying to practice intermittent fasting initially till it becomes a habit. So you would have to restrain yourself bearing that hunger for like 16 or 18 hours or the whole day in the initial phase till you get used to it. So that restraining can look like some a disadvantage to someone, but that is also an advantage, because keeping a restraint on yourself, keeping yourself in constraints, is also necessary for a human being. Learning on keeping yourself in constraints is also a good thing for a human being, also a necessary thing for a human being. One should practice it. So basically, then again we come back to, there are no significant disadvantages. That means only advantages. Boom. Okay, if there are so many advantages, then why not discuss one more advantage? See, till now the advantages that we have discussed are the advantages that you get, the benefits that you get. Now we are going to discuss a benefit that someone else would get from you doing intermittent fasting. See, when you do intermittent fasting, let's say a full day fast, upvas, there you would not be eating for the whole day, or when you are eating only in 6 hour frame and not eating in 18 hour window, so it would not be generally possible to eat all the food that you would eat if you were eating all day in just 6 hours. So there would be some food that you would not be able to eat, so you would be eating a bit lesser than what you would eat if you were to eat the whole day. So the amount of food that you are not eating, that gets spare, is saved for someone else on the earth to eat. Someone who is needy, someone who is hungry, someone who is poor. So the food that you did not eat, the food that you spared, is available to someone else, is available for someone else to eat. So that is like, you are getting so many benefits of intermittent fasting, and you are giving a really big benefit to someone else also. So basically, you feed someone else by getting these benefits of intermittent fasting. So if you think that I am talking some sort of nonsensical benefits, so let me tell you, around the time of independence of India, it was either prime minister or president, I forgot, but I think it was prime minister, who said that when requested people to eat just one time in a day, so that one meal that they did not eat could be eaten by someone else. We were really poor back then, but we are not that poor now. We are in a much better condition, but still there are hungry, poor, needy people. Even in India and even outside. So when you do not eat something, it is spare, it is left for someone else to eat. So basically you are feeding someone doing intermittent fasting. If you like this video, please like, comment, and share. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.